The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, fourth chapter, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada.
Translation. Some yogis perfectly worship the demigods by offering different sacrifices to them, and some of them offer sacrifices in the fire of the Supreme Brahma.
There are different types of yoga, sacrifices, and the person who offers sacrifices is called yogi. Daivameva apare yagyam yogina prajupasat. Yagyam yogina. Generally, the Vedas are divided into three types of yagya: karma kanda, jnana kanda, and upasana kanda. Generally, the yagyas are performed for satisfying the Supreme Personality of God. But one who hasn't got the chance of understanding the Supreme Personality of Godhead, they offer different types of yoga for satisfying the demigods. Here it is said, Daivam, in the matter of satisfying the different demigods. In the Shastra, it is recommended. After all, performance of yoga means to get the necessities of life. In the Shastra, it is recommended that if you want this type of benefit, then you offer yoga or try to satisfy this kind of demigod. There is a list in the Srimad Bhagavatam. If you want education, you worship this demigod. If you want very beautiful wife, then you worship this goddess. If you want good health, then you worship this demigod. If you want victory, so many ways. And we have got different types of demands. But that is recommended in the Shastra, in the Vedas, because gradually one has to be taken to the transcendental position to worship a type of demigod for certain type of benefit. At least it indicates that you can get the benefit from higher authorities. Indirectly, the higher authority is accepted. Otherwise, we become atheist. To save the general people from atheism, there is a recommendation for worshipping different types of demigods. Generally, they are recommended five: the sun god, the Ganesh, the Vishnu, Lord Shiva, and Durga, and this sun god I have already said. Five, Panchopasana. Five, the sun god, the Ganesh, and the Durga, Devi, then Lord Shiva, and then Vishnu. This is also gradual evolutionary. People in the most lowest stage of humanity, they are struck with wonder by the power. As soon as there is some electricity, they feel some power. So when they are a power worshipper, the modern scientists, their power worshipper, they have gone up to the sun god, not god, the sun globe. The power is received from the sun, sign. So this is one stage, power. In this way, one after another, when one comes to the supreme powerful, Vishnu, because that is the ultimate, powerful. So this is one type of yoga, understanding the supreme power. Just like I was talking a few minutes before, the power. But power is not ultimate. Ultimate is the conductor of power, or the powerful. Just like electricity. Electricity is power, but it is generated from the powerhouse. People generally understand that electricity is coming from the powerhouse. But the powerhouse is maintained by the resident engineer, a person. That is real understanding. Or just like this aeroplane is flying in the sky, a child may see that a wonderful machine is flying in the sky. He does not know the importance of the pilot, the big gigantic airship can fly in the sky, so long the powerful, or one who knows how to conduct the power, pushing the button. By pushing one button, the plane goes high, and pushing another body, it comes down. It is not automatically. Any machine you take, nowadays wonderful machine is computer. That is also handled by an expert. Any machine you take, without an expert technologist, it cannot work. So, similarly, if you go on studying the power of material nature, you'll come ultimately to the Supreme Personality of God. That is explained in the Bhagavad Gita. Maya dhakshena prakriti suhati sa characharam hetu nane na kauntiya jagat bi parivartate. Krishna says, Maya, by me, adhakshena, by my superintendence, Maya adhakshena, everything is working. That is also confirmed in the Brahma Sangita. Srishti sthiti pralaya sadhana shakti reka chaye vajasya bhuvanani vivarti durga. This power, material nature, is called Durga. So Durga, the material nature, Durga means the predominating deity of this fort. Durga, Durga means fort. And Durga means where it is very difficult to enter. The fort is fortified. Therefore, it is called Durga. One can, go means going, and do means difficult. Therefore, fort is, the Sanskrit name of fort is called Durga. And the predominating deity, it is called Durga. Similarly, this material world, universe, it is covered by several layers. And one layer, the first layer is there, and the second layer is 10 times thicker than the first layer. The third layer is 10 times thicker than the second layer. In this way, this universe is covered tight. Very fortified. and there are innumerable universes. They are clustered together. And all these universes together is called the material world. And this is a very fortified place, and the predominating deity of this material world, Srishti Sthiti Pralaya Sadhana Shakti Reka, there is a power that is called Durga. Srishti Sthiti Pralaya Sadhana Shakti Reka Chhayi Vajasab Bhavanani Vibharti Durga. Ichhalu Rupamapi Jasahi Cheshtati Sa. Although this Durga is so powerful that she can create, she can maintain, and she can dissolve the whole cosmic manifestation. It is so powerful. At any moment, it can dissolve. But she is working just like chayeva. Chaya means shadow. Just like you have your hand, and here is the shadow. If the hand moves, then shadow moves. Therefore, it is said, chayeva jasa.
To God, by his estimating his activities, then this name, Krishna, is the most perfect name. Impersonally, they say, the God has no name. We also accept that. God has no name, but his name is given. There are Vishnu Sahasra name, thousands of names. Now how one man can be, or one person can have thousand names, we can very easily understand. Just like a person working as high court judge, here he is, there he is addressed, my lord. And amongst the friend, he is addressed by the name, or at house by his wife, or by the children, he is addressed as father. In this way, he might have many names, but the person is one. Similarly, although there are Vishnu Sahasranam, the person is the same, and the proper name, factual name, is Krishna. Krishna means all-attract, supreme, para-brahma. These are described in the Shastra. So, all the big authorities in spiritual science, they have